Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, your station where you get to watch and learn. I'm your tutor Mr. Mangi Francis, taking you through physics form 1. Stay tuned throughout the lesson and do pay attention. So what are the goals of this lesson? By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to 1. Define momentum. Number 2. You'll also be able to solve problems involving momentum. So for us to be able to get this, we need to recall the Newton's first law of motion, and this law explains the effects of forces on the bodies, on the motion of bodies. So forces are responsible for the motion of bodies and also the stopping of the object. These are the effects of force. Now, Newton's first law: a body remains in its state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line unless acted upon by an external force. So explaining why the passenger in the vehicle tend to keep moving when the vehicle stops abruptly. From the law of inertia, the passenger will remain on uniform motion along a straight line unless acted upon by an external force. Now, what is the reason why this happens? This is due to momentum. Momentum can be defined as the product of mass of a body and its velocity. So, a heavy commercial vehicle will require a lot of force to start when loaded than when empty. This means that a greater mass will require a greater force for it to move. So, consequently, from the formula, momentum therefore is the mass, is the product of mass and velocity. Then how do we express the SI unit of momentum? Mass is measured in kilogram, while velocity is given in meters per second. And therefore, the SI unit of momentum becomes kilogram meter per second. Now let's look at the following question. A car of mass 300 kilogram is traveling at a velocity of 72 kilometers per hour. So we are required to calculate the momentum of the vehicle. Now, how do we solve this? Remember, it is important for us to convert and work in SI unit. Therefore, the mass of the car is provided as 300 kilograms, which is the SI unit of mass, but the velocity is given in kilometers per hour. So we need to convert 72 kilometers per hour into meters per second, which is equivalent to 20 meters per second. Then from our formula, momentum, which is given by mass times velocity, then we have the product of 300 kilogram and 20, the product of 320, which gives us a total of 6,000 kilogram meter per second. Now let's see whether we can be able to apply the same concept and solve the following question. A car is moving at 10 meters per second. Which velocity will double its momentum? So in this case, we are required to get the velocity that will double the momentum of this vehicle. So you can refer this into Secondary Physics Students Book 3, or you can give us a text through the numbers on your screen, or visit our YouTube channel at Elimu TV, or Facebook page at Elimu TV, or give us a tweet at @ElimuTV_KE, that is our Twitter handle. Most importantly, stay tuned in Elimu TV, which is your station where you get to learn and experience. Thank you.